Despite record low unemployment, states are using gimmicks to waive food stamp work requirements for able-bodied, childless adults. In fact, one-third of the country doesn't have to meet the requirement. That's wrong. We must help more able-bodied Americans move from welfare to work. Recently, USDA proposed fixing the food stamp work requirement rules. But the proposal only fixes half the problem. That's not good enough. What's the problem? Under the proposal, states could still game the system using labor market areas. Labor market areas are meant to define metropolitan areas. Relying on labor market areas would require fewer than 1 million more people to meet the work requirement. How? States could keep gerrymandering. An area can get a waiver even if it is surrounded by jobs. States could end up waiving jurisdictions that are not currently waived. The solution? Commuting zones. Commuting zones are a tool drawn by USDA to identify interconnected commuting zones. Commuting zones avoid the problems of labor market areas. With commuting zones, nearly 2 million people would be asked to meet the work requirements. Double the impact. Let's visualize this. Here's the status quo of waivers right now. Not good. That's a lot of able-bodied adults lacking a work requirement. Now, let's look at the waived areas based off the proposed rule. It gets better, but a lot of people will still be waived. Finally, here are the waived areas when the commuter zone concept is applied. More work, more dignity, more opportunity. Bottom line, using commuting zones makes more sense, and it will change more lives for the better. Learn more at thefga.org/commutingzones.